You might remember around April of 2020, there was this video that came out, and it went very viral very fast. And it was of this man with a British accent telling a story to his children about all that had happened during the pandemic. And when I first saw this video, I said, who in the world is telling this story to a child? What are we doing here? What is this? But then I watched a little further, and I realized that what he was doing was telling the story of the lessons we could learn from the pandemic. He envisioned a world where everyone learned how to care for creation, how to make better choices with our time, how to honor the gifts in each of us, how to keep one another safe, how to see the presence of God in all people, how to be present, how to be right here. Well, we're 20 months into the pandemic, and I'm not totally sure that all of those beautiful lessons have fully sunk in for us yet. I think we're still working on it. I think that because I look at our world and I realize that we've kind of snapped back to the breakneck pace we had going before. The choices we're making right now, myself included, and many of us and folks who are sitting at home right now, we're making them because we feel like we have to keep up. Like we have to show up for all the different things we are called to do, asked to do. We find ourselves people-pleasing and ladder-climbing, and I wonder where the lesson is in that for us. I wonder what it would look like for us to simply be present, for us to make choices about what we will or will not do, what we will or will not give. I wonder how we could be present in this moment, to turn off the noise, to shut it all out, and to just be right here, to offer what we have to God, to offer what we have to our neighbors, and to make life a little more simple. I think the widow in our story has some answers for us about that today. You see, she went into this temple, and she gave all that she had, her 2 coins. Jesus uses the widow in this story as an example of a faithful person, a person who shows up fully before God. And here's the thing. A widow in ancient Israel was someone who was deeply vulnerable, someone who wasn't well cared for, someone who was often left alone. And so when she comes into the temple, Jesus sees her and understands that what she is giving is all she has to give. What she is offering is all of herself before God. Actually, the translation that we just heard, she gave all she had to live on, can also be translated as she gave her whole life. She showed up with her whole life before God. We understand that we're not asked to put our whole lives before God, or actually, maybe we are. Maybe we are asked to show up before God as our whole and fullest selves, as the people God has truly called us to be. I wonder about that. I wonder about what it is that caught Jesus so by surprise by this woman. Because it happens in the context of all these other wealthy people giving from their abundance, giving from the part they wouldn't miss, giving from the excess, giving from whatever was left over from everything else they'd already done in their week. You could think about what this widow is doing, like jumping into the deep end of the pool. She dumps whole in, everything in, while the wealthy folk are putting a toe in the shallow end, testing it out, seeing what works and what doesn't, but waiting, not fully present. The difference between the widow and the wealthy, besides the obvious socioeconomic situation, is the emotional commitment to God and to neighbor. This morning, we're invited to see the widow as a fully human example of faith, a glimpse into the courage and wisdom that comes with showing up fully before God and neighbor. I was struggling with this scripture quite a bit last week, and so I was talking with Taylor about something else. And she reminded me that the widow gives like God gives. The widow gives without reservation, or thought, or fear. She gives with courage and with hope. Beloved, we worship a God who is generous, ever flowing, never ending. The wealthy give with a scarcity mindset. They give with the mind that there will not be enough, that more will not come in, that they can only give what is left over. The widow gives all that she has in the moment, trusting that God will be faithful, that God already is faithful, trusting that God will be who she says that she is. Now, I'm not suggesting that we burn ourselves out. I just want to make that very clear. I'm not suggesting that we show up and pour out like God pours out into everything all the time with no boundaries. That is not the suggestion here. What I am offering is that what if we showed up to this moment with whatever it is we have? Maybe all we have in this moment is 2 coins, but we give those 2 coins freely, full of hope, full of possibility. Maybe all we have is 30 minutes, but we are present in those 30 minutes with the person in front of us and with the God who loves us. We each have competing things going on in our lives. We each have competing needs and desires and commitments. But what if we showed up to each of them, present, fully ready to see what will happen in that interaction, what will happen in that conversation, what God will do among us? What if? What if? What if we allowed, for just a second, ourselves to be vulnerable to the person in front of us? What if we shared what we had to give, not because we were afraid we wouldn't have more later, but because we trust that we can be fed in the sharing? I want to tell you a story, and it's a very recent story. It happened last night. Last night, I took a 3-hour dance workshop, and it was called Reclaim. We sat in a circle at the very beginning, and we journaled about what we wanted to reclaim within ourselves and reclaim within our movements and within our lives. We went around, and we shared our words, and as people reclaimed themselves, they also reclaim safety and peace and confidence and self-worth and hope. We danced and we cheered for one another. We danced in groups and we danced in solos. God help us. At one point, our instructor had us just stop what we were doing, put our hands over our hearts, and shout what we have reclaimed. Speak it into being. Stop what we're doing, stop all the movements, stop all the busyness, and just be here, grounded and present. It was like an earthquake, what happened in the room. When everyone stopped worrying about how to move and what to do and what they looked like, and just stayed still, and just was present to the moment. At South Church this month, we're focusing on gratitude. And I have to tell you that there can be no gratitude without presence. We can never recognize the gifts unless we're stopping to notice them and see them. So after that earthquake of spiritual connection in the room, we recognize that we had showed up as our fullest selves and that we had offered the 2 coins we had to give to that moment. There's 2 things that we say a lot in dance. It's not a mess up, it's your solo, and going full out. And so what full out means is that we're not worrying about the choreo, we're not worrying about anything else, we are just going to do this. We are just going to be here. We are just going to be present to whatever will come from this music. And I think that perhaps in a world that's constantly asking us to go faster and do more and be all over the place all the time, filling everyone else's needs, doing all the things, that maybe giving ourselves a moment to be full out in one space and in one moment and at one time might just be a real gift, not just to us, but to the people around us, to the folks that we meet, to the God who loves us. Because here's the thing. We remember, the widow gives like God gives, unreserved, without fear, without any barriers. So maybe we can give that back to God this week. Maybe we can be present this week. When our attentions are pulled and our bodies are all over the place and our fears seem to take control, what if we found time to just be right here? To say no to all of the things that pull our attention, and to be present to the ways that God is here for us right now. What if we were like the widow, diving deep, going deep, figuring out the ways that God is faithful, being open to what is possible? I pray that whatever your life looks like right now, whatever commitments are pulling you, however God is showing up for you, that you'll give your two coins this week. Not your finances, not your resources, your two coins of attention and time, so that we might be present to God, present to one another, and find the gratitude therein. May it be so. Amen.